Hello friends, today we are going to perform experiment on routine test on transformer. Our aim is today to perform routine test on 3 phase 1 kVA 440 volt, 220 volt, 50 hertz star connected air cooled transformer. We are going to perform measurement of winding resistance of HV side only, voltage ratio and no load loss and no load current. As per IS code 2026 for oil immersed transformer and IS code 11171 for dry type transformer greater than 5 kV rating, following are routine tests to be performed to check performance parameter of new units or to ascertain the parameters claimed by manufacturer after repairs. Shifting of transformer or to know the status of the transformer after put into service, following routine tests are performed. First one is the measurement of winding resistance, second is the measurement of voltage ratio, third one is checking of phase displacement, fourth one measurement of short circuit impedance and load loss. Fifth is measurement of no load loss and no load current. Sixth is dielectric routine test and test on tap load tap changer if the tap changer is available. So out of this routine test, we are confined our experiment for today's air cooled dry type transformer, which is available in our lab. Measurement of winding resistance of HV side, no load loss and no load current, and voltage ratio. These three tests we are going to perform as a experiment, part of experiment. Measurement of winding resistance of HV side and LV side is usually done by applying DC voltage to the winding. Limiting to test current should not exceed 10% of full load current rating. The temperature at the time of measurement is recorded. The resistance measured at specified temperature should be converted to standard temperature of 75 degrees Celsius by using conversion formula R75 is equal to RT into bracket 235 plus 75 divided by 235 plus T for the copper winding. The converted resistance at 75 degrees Celsius should be less than or equal to 2% of factory test value. Measurement of winding resistance gives the fair idea of the condition of the winding, such as intern shorted turns, loose connection of bushing or terminals, loose connection or high contact resistance on tap changer, and broken winding strands. Before performing the winding resistance test, the preparation of transformer to make it ready is must. For oil immersed transformer, it has to be kept idle under oil without excitation for at least 3 to 4 hours. The average oil temperature is to be considered for the resistance measurement. The difference between top oil temperature and bottom oil temperature should be small as possible, in the range of 1 to 3 degrees Celsius. To reduce the difference of at faster rate, oil may be circulated using pump. For dry type transformer, the transformer shall be at rest in constant ambient temperature for at least 3 hours without excitation. To avoid errors in the reading, the test should be performed on all winding as quickly as possible to avoid temperature rise in the winding. For experimentation setup, the diagram is given here. A transformer winding, whatever is there, it is connected in star first, okay, and then for the transformer, because it has a six terminals are available, we made it available for the winding with the common made with the neutral. Then a DC source is available here to provide test voltage, as well as we have connected ammeter and we are switching it to the respective windings, and corresponding test current we are going to pass through the winding, respective windings, and we are measuring the record. So this is the setup for the measurement of winding resistance. Okay, transformer is 1 kVA 3 phase 50 hertz, starts are connected, dry type air natural transformer of copper wound, that's our test circuit. So in our test setup, what we have: a DC source, regulated DC power supply, then we have connected a potential rheostat for the as a potentiometer to vary the voltage gradually and precisely. We have connected an ammeter as a DC multimeter, multimeter as an ammeter. Then the output of the second terminal of the ammeter, the multimeter is connected to the respective winding, say R, then Y, and then blue. So we are going to measure the per phase resistance of the winding. So voltage is also measured across the winding by a voltmeter, digital voltmeter. Digital voltmeter, so corresponding voltage can be measured. Experiment, we have recorded ambient temperature as a 31 degree Celsius with the start of the experiment. The rated current of the winding of the three phase transformer given is 1.312 ampere. It is calculated by using the KVA formula. That is a VA rating of the three phase transformer is equal to root 3 times into VL into IL, and we have found out the HU winding current rating. So it is found at 1.312, and maximum test current can be passed, that is 0.1312 ampere or 13.2 milliampere. So this is a limit of our passing the current to avoid any temperature rise because of the excessive current through the winding, to 10% of the rating of the winding. So we have restricted our three set of current reading: 5.5 milliampere, 10 milliampere, or 12 milliampere, and we are just finding out the voltage for 32 millivolt. It was observed on the resistor across the winding, 60 millivolt for the 10 milliampere and 72 millivolt for the 12 milliampere. Similarly, now we are going to perform the resistance of the to find out the Y winding. Mr. Ashish and Miss Nikita will perform the experiment to show the measurement of winding resistance of yellow phase and blue phase immediately. So start the experiment, connect the output of the ammeter, make it zero. First you make it zero, this connect the output to the Y winding, simultaneously the voltage, yes, correct. Alright, now slowly increase the increase the potentiometer to pass the current to 5 milliampere. Now it is showing reading there that we will take 7 milliampere. Just steady state value we have to obtain. 5.5. It is 5.63 milliampere. Write down. And voltage is
32
millivolt. Increase the current, so 10.16 and voltage is 61.2 millivolt. Okay. Increase further the current, next value to 12 milliamps. Okay, that's it, fine. So current is now third value, 12.45 average value, and here
73.6. 73.6.
fine. In this way, you perform the three readings to take the average reading as quickly as possible to reduce the temperature rise.
Okay.
Average value will be considered and the resistance will be converted to the standard degree temperature of the 75 degree Celsius by converting formula. For hello student, second part of our routine test on transformer, that is measurement of voltage ratio, that we are going to perform now. The measurement of voltage ratio as per IS 2026, we have to perform to test, has a primary importance in the transformer testing. As per the design and manufacturing specification, rated output voltage is to be obtained for rated input excitation voltage at the terminals of the appropriate winding. According to voltage ratio, the specified rated input voltage must be available at all tappings. This test is generally carried out with the help of trans ratio meter or voltage ratio meter for accurate measurement. However, this also can be performed by injecting a rated LV side voltage at rated frequency into HU winding, that is the principal winding or main winding, and output is measured at the terminals of LV winding. For such measurement, output voltage at LV side by using precision voltmeter. So what we will do, the HV side voltage and LV side voltage is there for the transformer. To measure the voltage ratio, what we will do, we will supply LV side voltage to the HV side winding and correspondingly output is measured at the LV side. This is a regular practice as per the IS standard 2026 to be performed on all power transformer, distribution transformer of all types. As in our laboratory, we have a small transformer 1 kVA rating. So similar methodology we are going to apply to perform the voltage ratio test. This is not as our traditional laboratory experiment. We are giving primary to the full voltage and measuring the output at the secondary voltage. That is not a practice. We are performing the voltage ratio as per the IS standard 2026 test method.
Okay.
The acceptance of the voltage ratio measured value should be equal to calculated factory ratio of plus minus 0.5%. The deviation of plus minus 0.5% is at no load condition. If the deviation is large, this determines the interturn short in the winding. If any open in the LV winding and normal level of exciting current, very low level of unstable output voltage indicated by voltmeter or 0 volt. And circuit setup is explained here. This is a circuit diagram for the voltage setup. Our given transformer is star connected. We require 3 phase auto transformer to get variable voltage supply. We have connected this variable output of the variable transformer to the corresponding terminals of the R, Y and B of HV side, and LV side is also star connected where we are going to measure the output voltage. Okay. The observation table is given here. What we are going to observe, input line voltage we had applied here, we are going to apply 220 volt as this is the rated voltage of the LV side. This is the rated voltage of LV side. The HV side of this transformer is 440 volt and LV side is a 220 volt. So as per the test practice, what we will do, we will supply LV side 220 volt as an input to the HV side and corresponding whatever is the voltage induced and available at the terminals of the respective phase winding, that we are going to measure here as an output voltage. This is the so test procedure. The equipments are here available. The three phase 1 kVA 440 volt 220 volt starts are connected 50 hertz air natural dry type air transformer. 5 kVA 3 phase auto transformer will be required to obtain the variable voltage. 2 RMS multimeter or 2 RMS clamp on meter is available with us, or we can also measure with the help of AC voltmeter analog of 0 to 300 and 0 to 150 volt. For our measurement we have 2 RMS multimeter here. Clamp on voltmeter is there. Procedure: connections are added as per circuit diagram. In the given transformer, 440 volt 220 volt HV side is 440 volt and LV side is 220 volt. As per IS 2026 test procedure, a rated low voltage is applied, LV voltage, low voltage is applied to high voltage winding and output is measured across the LV terminals. Step number 2, gradually increase the supply voltage to 220 volt. Measurement of phase to neutral at supply input side and corresponding output at the respective phase to neutral of LV side is recorded. The ratio of output to input voltage is calculated and compare it with the design voltage ratio. Then after finishing, supply is gradually reduced and disconnected. Supply is taken. A three phase supply is taken and connected to the input to the auto transformer, and output of the transformer correspondingly connected to the transformer HV side, R, Y and B phase of the HV side. Now experiment is going to perform by Mr. Ashish and Ms. Nikita. Dual voltage ratio. Mr. Ashish, please make the supply switch on. Now increase the gradually voltage of the from the auto transformer to record line to line voltage as 220 volt. So it is now recording 220 as a LV side voltage we are injecting into the LV HV side. Once again we are, as per the test practice of 2026, we are supplying rated voltage of LV winding, that is 220 volt for our transformer. It is supplied to the HV side as a 220 volt, and then correspondent voltage with respect to the terminals we are going to make it here, check it here. So what we are going to check here, the right now the input voltage line to line voltage is given, that is 220 volt, liquid 220 volt. Okay, so phase voltage now you have to check with respect to neutral. Phase voltage we are now checking
127.
It is 127, recording as 127. Okay, then output voltage now measured. With respect to R, phase voltage, output voltage, phase voltage, it is coming out, make it average value 65.
9 voltage.
Okay. So correspondingly now for Y phase, Y and neutral, Y and neutral, it is 130.8. Correspondingly output voltage of the secondary LV side, it is 67.3. For B phase it is 136.6. And correspondingly for output voltage it is 70.6. okay,